This is a familiar story. People from developing countries churning out products for an insatiable global market. But what if those products are made in Japan and expose claims of exploitation on a government immigration scheme?
五年时间都没有休息，全厂全工厂里面只有我一个人，我又不会开多少，不想活了，然后我就从楼梯上面就跳了下来。
There were supposed to be interns coming to Japan to earn money and learn skills, but instead they claim they were exploited on a government scheme that involves thousands of businesses, including some of the country's best-known brands. Japan says it needs migrants, but does it want them? It's industrial towns like this that most of these migrant workers end up in. And that's because these are the places that Japanese businesses really struggle to find staff. There's a shelter just near here, and it's been taking in migrants from Vietnam and China and Cambodia and helping them with legal cases against their employers.
刚来的时候是早上六点半到十二点下班，不年时间都没有休息，没有休息天。我就是一个儿子，就是一个孩子。Zhang
came to Japan to earn money to pay for a nice wedding for her son. She worked in a small company making clothes, where she claims she was exploited.
工资呢？这是东西，全是做假，全做的假账。
She showed me notes she says she took for a year, documenting the hours that she worked. She says she wasn't paid for any of her overtime and claims that she's owed nearly
$50,000.
We spoke to two other people, also from China, who made similar allegations about the working practices at this company. The company have denied this. They say all employees were paid minimum wage and that they abide by all employment laws, including working hours. And they maintain that their payslips are accurate. They also said employees were free to leave the building and were allowed to go to the supermarket even after the start of the workday.
So these are labels that you sewed onto clothes. This one's Comme des Garçons. Do you remember seeing that a lot? This one is for Barney's, New York.
We put these allegations to Barney's, New York, and to Comme des Garçons. Both companies distanced themselves from this factory and said that it was used as a result of uncontrolled outsourcing in their supply chain. Comme des Garçons say they insist on strict conditions with regards to staff working conditions, health and safety for all of the factories that they work with, and that this one was hired by a subcontractor without their knowledge or consent. They said their subcontractor is taking due action and have assured us this will never happen again. Barney's New York said it didn't order anything directly from this company and that it's in the process of investigating. There are 6,000 companies employing technical interns in Japan. In a 2017 report, the Japanese government found that 70% of them had broken labor regulations on illegal and unpaid overtime. So why did a government scheme become so mired in abuse? For centuries, Japan closed itself off from the outside, becoming one of the most homogeneous societies in the world. Now it's facing a demographic time bomb. It desperately needs workers, and the internship scheme became a way for companies to hire cheap labor from abroad. But many interns don't speak Japanese, and few are properly informed of their rights, leaving them vulnerable to abuse. And we've spoken to technical interns who worked for other companies who have harrowing stories to tell.
来到日本之后，感觉跟自己想象一样，都是蛮好的，这个环境蛮好的。对。
In China, Huang studied Japanese. He came here hoping to get fluent and he got work in a box factory.
我跟他打招呼，他不跟我打招呼，然后这样子跟上司也是，他也不怎么教我嘛，他就是感觉跟他说日语，他说他听不明白，然后就，但是被那个机器给卷进去了，又让我回国，不给我治疗，还让我逼我签一个协议，当时我没有签嘛。
He's trying to get compensation, but the factory owner is claiming bankruptcy. And if that succeeds, it'll be as if Wang and his accident never happened. Zheng Kai manages the shelter where Wang and Zhang are staying.
大家待在那儿不也是没有事情做吗？所以这也是通过这个是一个交流沟通和也算一个活动吧。现在不能动，一动他妈死了，是不是？可能是在人前跟大家可能大家开玩笑干嘛，我可能这会我可以跟你有说有笑的，但是我可能一转身我就会立马就会哭了起来，完全就是不是以前的我。
Xu was intensely bullied at work. She felt she was singled out for being foreign.
我们那个流水线上就我一个女性，他们平常就有时候没事爱开我玩笑嘛，就说男女性之间开那种玩笑嘛，我就说他们班长，我就说八嘎，开玩笑说了句八嘎。当时我们系长在那里，就勃然大怒，真的当时就勃然大怒，他说。 你是英雄，你是中国人，你在日本工作，我们说你什么骂你什么，你就只能听着，你就不可以还嘴。然后，就到后来吃饭的时候，坐在那休息嘛，我就看着他天空，我说太累了，我说真的在这边太累了，我说不想活了，然后就回来就在火车就想不开嘛，然后就从楼梯上面就跳了下来。
She spent 3 months in hospital and has damaged her back. She may not be able to work again. Now she's fighting to have the incident recognized as a workplace injury.
不到日本来工作，我怎么会发生这些事情？你平常中你工作不是说对我太过于挑剔的话，我不至于说我想不开。In
its report, Japan's Justice Ministry said that 157 technical interns died in 5 years, 17 by suicide. Activists say the real figure is much higher. These people came to Japan with dreams of seeing the world, of learning and saving for their future. Instead, they were treated as cheap labor. This year, Japan is opening up to more low-skilled immigrants than it's ever done in its history. It will allow 345,000 people to come in the next 5 years. But as they arrive, Japan has to reckon with how it treats those who are already here.